Hey there, Divi lovers! I have a quick tutorial for you. I'm going to show you how to create a nice CSS only scrolling logo effect in Divi. Hi, my name is Anya, and my goal here is to help you build beautiful websites. So this is what I have for you today, a simple approach with no plugins, no JavaScript, just a few lines of CSS and a simple animation to create that infinite scrolling loop of little images for your Divi website. Let's get to work. Okay, so here I am in the Divi Builder inserting a new row, and I will use a single column row because I want to put more than six images next to each other. If you only have six logos to showcase, then this column structure is fine, but if you have more, my little CSS approach will work better. So inside my row, I want to add an image module. I have a sample logo right here. I do want to make some adjustments. So first in the design sizing, we'll set width to 150 pixels and then slightly smaller on fonts, 120. And I also want to control margin in the spacing. I want to add some margin to the right side of the image, let's say 30 pixel, to control the spacing between logos. And I also want to remove any bottom margin. Okay, so I have my image. Now I'm duplicating it. You could obviously use different images for each logo, but just to make this example simple, let's say I'm going to use that many. Now, to align them next to each other in my row column settings, advanced custom CSS, we are targeting the column with the selector keyword and using display flex. Now that changes the width of my images because it tries to fit everything in one line. So in addition to that, I want to change the size of my row. So I can't go into design sizing in my row settings, changing the width, because I do want to use a max content unit. In my row settings, advanced tab, custom CSS. Now I'm targeting the row with the selector keyword. Max width, max content, and width, max content. That means the row will be as wide as the images inside, basically. Okay, so now that I have my row with all the images, and let's maybe duplicate it one more time so that it fills the entire available space. So what you want to do is to duplicate the row. We need two instances of the same row so that when we animate it away from the screen, as it goes away, the new row comes in. So that's why we need two. I'm duplicating the row. You want to have the same logos repeated for the second time in the second row in Divi right here. Now we go to the section settings. In the advanced custom CSS, we are also using display flex to put these two rows next to each other. Again, targeting the thing that I'm editing, section in this case, with the selector keyword and display flex. Okay, just like that, the second row went to the side. And now to prevent the entire page from shifting sideways, we want to add a horizontal overflow. I mean, hide the overflow. So in the visibility, horizontal overflow hidden, vertical hidden. Okay, we have two rows next to each other with logos. Now we need to animate them. We want to animate the rows, but instead of adding the CSS twice in each row, I can target the rows by using custom CSS on the section level, by using selector keyword as the parent, selector, and then ETPB row class, which is a standard CSS class added to every row. Now my row needs to animate animation. Let's call it ticker, that's the animation name, then timing function, linear, but first the duration, so 30 seconds, linear, infinite. That means that it will animate smoothly without any easing, and it will repeat animation over and over again. Now it doesn't do anything because the ticker animation is not defined. We have to define keyframes. Add keyframes, ticker. And now the syntax could include percentages if we would like to maybe define different steps within the animation. But if there's just two, we can use from and to. So from one set of properties to another. Now what we want to do is we want to start with the initial position of the row, and we want to move it to the side by its own width. We can use transform property to do that. So transform, translate x, moves elements horizontally. Initially, no movement, so translate x 0, and then 2, negative 100%. And you can already see the animation is working. There's just one more thing I like to include, is to pause the animation on hover. When hovering over the section, we want the animation on the row to stop. So selector, hover, ETPB row. So I'm targeting the row, but only when the parent container is being hovered over. And we have animation play state property we can use. Sorry, I'm terrible at typing. Play state paused. Okay, and now as I hover the section, my logos will get paused. Okay, let's save and check how it looks on the front end. If we check smaller screen sizes, it will look nice on tablets and phones as well. And as we hover, the animation will stop. So we can copy the CSS I use from my blog post. It's super simple, no special plugins, no JavaScript, just a few lines of CSS to get that scrolling effect. And that's it. I hope it was helpful. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.